to fight. Round begins in 3, 2, 1. Fight.
Yep, Rosita gets the mega hot spawn. And that means that Stone gets the heavy. Stone has the lightning gun. But won't have much else. Well, he walks into the shotgun cupboard, but also connects his own spit, so Sita won't chase, but wow, he activates his ability and just hugs Stone while shooting his rockets. Sita is pretty effective with this gem. And just like that, he has his ability back up. And he conquers himself the heavy. Strings the mega health. After it then, oh yeah, Stone is just still so weak. Oh, but wow, Stone's defensive rocket gave him a lifeline. It's also the case that Pesita couldn't hit his shotgun blast, which would have been a kill shot. But now, wow, the tribal. Oh, there's no health bubble in this corner. Where did Pesita spawn? I think he has lightning gun. Yeah. He can certainly follow this up. Oh, but Stone takes a stance and does a lot of LG damage before dying. Unfortunately, there isn't an item up for him to stack back up, so they have to fight for the poverty items. The first major item goes to Stone. He has to do a great deal of walking to get to the mega health. It goes to Pesita, but he also dies right after it. True. This is the same match we had in the winner bracket final. But we might have a different winner. Wow. Oh, Stone isn't able to deny the mega health mid-fight for Pesita, so he falls. Pesita had so much opening damage into that fight, but Stone anticipated it and greets him with some tasty rockets. Oh, look at the position Pesita is having. Well, it doesn't really pay out for him. It was a ballsy move. I do like it. It took a while before Stone realized what was happening. He had his lightning gun ready.
Time. Stopwatch.
Defense systems initiated.
Lead tied.
Stone lost track of Pesita mid fight. Yeah, well, the shield is down. Stone wants to be aggressive, but he also does not want to walk into his defensive rockets. He walks into a lot in the end. And Pesita gets the mega health and his shield back up. Plus another frag.
Drill.
14 health left after that fight with Stone.
5 minute warning.
So he did die up the game, but he paid a lot of stack for it and also lost a bit of his control. The mega health went to the robot. And now also the opening damage. Sita almost sent himself. But with his dash, he moved back in. Yeah, if Stone isn't able to deny the control and the timefall game Pesita is having right now, then we might have the same winner as last timefall game. Oh, the rockets from Pesita. It just opens up the next frag. And yeah, Stone has enough. GG, next map. So, Pesita prevails. And he is on turning point. And next map is Deep Embrace. Pesita is a ranger and Stone is a Doom Slayer.
In 3, 2, 1, fight. Time.
Oh, Stone doesn't connect his kill shot. Does get it in the end, and also pretty great timing of that frag. He can stack back up on the heavy. Well, Pesita took the mega health, also a light, but that one gets removed with the rail from Stone. Hello, Pesita is just walking back and forth. Trying to bait movements from Stone so he can get to a weapon. I think he only has lightning gun. Well, in the end they retreat to their own item, and now Stone is baiting the light, and Sita thinks something is up because he hasn't heard Stone in a while. There will be a point that they want to engage, right? Or at least switch item. Yeah, Pesita is delaying the mega health for quite some time. And now he just collected the railgun. And Stone is fumbling his movement a bit. He might vacate the area. And wow, now the delay will pay dividends for Pesita. Stone is aware of what happened. Oh, that rocket. Oh, unfortunately, it does not do that much. But the Tribolt is hurting. But oh, yeah, as soon as Pesita gets the mega health, he uses his orb. But he gets greeted by two consecutive rail shots from Stone, who gets the first frag. But oh, Pesita, right after he spawns, he takes position on the heavy. So that item goes to him, but Stone removes all of the stack Pesita got from it. He's... also... the Tribolt and the spawn force, and Stone doesn't even need to get a frag. Pesita frags himself. So a much better start from Stone this time around. His rail shot is missing though. And Pesita is doing a small amount of damage in return. Yeah, there are no items for him. Oh, as soon as the bubbles spawn, he uses orb and gets the heavy. While the mega health goes to Stone. Oh, look at this. The rail is working magic. All and a 67 for free, followed by a 95, and Pesita is gone. He does evade the following up from Stone. Oh, but yeah, coming at you. Somehow he isn't aware where Stone is. He was just jumping around and. Was surprised that he was getting hit by Stone. So actually good move by Stone. He was just silent, holding the upper ground at the armor, which gave him a lot of free damage and an end to the next frag.
5 minute warning.
And Pesita has nothing to show for. He has position on the heavy, but not the stack to survive anything from Stone. Oh, he gets... Ooh. I almost looked like another raid. A good switch to the shotgun. That is more consistent damage than a missing drill. And this time around, Pesita throws the towel in the ring. So, this isn't over yet. Next map will be Molten Falls. Where Stone is on Anarchy and Pesita is on Galena. What kind of flag is that? It's like a chicken in a circle in the middle of the flag. So if Stone takes this one, we will get an exile.
Pick up the pace. I will strike you down.
Prepare to fight. Round begins in 3, 2, 1. Fight.
May the power heal you.
Well, Stone will be happy with his spawn. He's playing the light and gets the heavy. Well, Pasita, well, does take a light before taking the Mega Elf. So there is a little bit of delay between the items. And they're just walking past each other. They want to collect the tools before entering the fight. And Stone is anticipating Pasita somewhere. Or maybe he was shopping for totems. But anyway, yeah, they exchange damage, but wow! The consecutive rail shots from Stone gets him the first frag. Oh, he does walk into one, but that only makes him stack back up on the light. Oh, but the follow-up is also there. Yeah, I do think Pasita only has a nail gun and rail. Stone can be aggressive. Oh, yeah. Unfortunately, his last rail does not connect, so the mega health will go to Pasita. Well, he takes the jump pad, which is a hint for Stone. And yeah, he didn't saw him go to the lightning gun, so he anticipated that Pasita went for the rocket launcher. He got some great damage because of that knowledge. And, oh, yeah, he has a great rotation going. He might even deny this light. And Pasita has no armor to his name. And yeah, well, Stone gladly takes this damage because he can deny this light also.
Stars.
But he still isn't sure of his case. There would be a point that he could be a little bit more aggressive, even use a rocket rocket jump to get into Pasita's face. But yeah, his tournament life is on the line, right? So he wants to be really sure to get a clean frag. Yeah, deny this light. Then go too heavy. Yeah, now he has too much armor to deny the light at the rail. But oh yeah, he takes the damage from Pasita, so he might just go there right now. Pasita does get the mega health, but oh, he walks into some unreturned damage. Oh, two rockets beneath his feet and he explodes. Stone gets another frag. While Pusita wasn't really close to a frag in any fight. So this makes the job of Pusita even harder. Especially because Stone is just continuing his rotation. Yeah, Stone doesn't really need to fight for the mega health. He has his inject if he needs health.
What?
Oh, man, bye bye. That was a flick rocket.
God, bag your face.
Yeah, Stone has this map on lockdown right now. So there is a high chance we will see Exile. But Pusita still has 4 minutes to do something in return. Let's give him some screen time.
Shameful tactics.
Yeah, well, Pusita did earn himself a heavy, but he's paying a lot of stack for it. And well, he is in time to get to the mega health, while Stone isn't there to punish the pickup. So especially after hitting that rail, there isn't in the next track for Pusita.
Do not die yet.
But he needs at least 5 of those to get back into this match. And yes. Well, he is able to shift the control. All he does is rotate Stone into the next major item. And Pusita has enough. GG, next map. So that means we go to the tiebreaker, and that is Exile. Where Pusita plays Skill Baba, and Stone plays Death Knight. Pusita isn't here, so he might have crashed. No, there he is. And he is on skill bar, so I think we'll just continue. Yeah, I think this is a challenge. It's always a challenge against skill bar, but on Exile, if you bait it on the bridge, the upper bridge, you can evade a bull rush, but on the other parts of the map it's not that easy to evade it. But we'll have an answer in 10 minutes. Okay, stone.
Prepare to fight.
Suicide Sword is flame strike. Yeah, let's start on the heavy settlement.
3, 2, 1, fight.
Oh, and he gets a great spawn. Look at the stack he's dealing with. And he gets a hint of where stone is. He isn't able to catch him though. So they probably both have all the tools they want in the next fight. And they're both loaded with their ability. Oh, nice! Oh, the flame strike just sends Pasito away. And, well, Stone? I'm surprised that he didn't have a real out. And Stone is able to evade the bull rush, and he practically baits Pasita into taking the jump pad, and he greets him with the lightning gun. Okay, frag for Stone. He might have lost on the mega health though. Oh, and he's also getting a lot of damage. But well, okay. Pasita is opting to go for the heavy. Yeah, that's also a more important item when you're playing scale. But it is also means that Stone can stack back up on the mega health.
Crush them. Tied.
Yeah, and this just the nature of the bull rush. You
stop watch.
As soon as the bull rush is going, you there's really no way to stop it. So either you escape it by using a rocket jump, or you just take the damage.
Combo kill. Lead taken.
Oh, nice rockets from Stone. And he gets it at the favorable moment. He gets both items. Yeah, look at the stack skill where he gets when he just spawns. Ooh, no, Stone is too early. But what? Okay. Okay, first of all, why the railgun, Papa Stone? But secondly, what was Sita doing there, just running around? Not taking the heavy. If Stone would have used something else then, it would have been a much easier frack. Now next up is Mega Elf. And after that there's a decent time to move to the heavy. Great, now Stone doesn't have to deal with the bull rush for quite some time. Because he also stole the time files near the rail, and he can also deny this one. Well, no, I think the time calls were still up on the rail, so yeah, in 10 seconds Pesita will have his boomers.
Stopwatch.
But now Stone has a lot of stones to deal with it. And yeah, and this is the way, right? Even if Pesita continues Stopwatch. With his whoops. Continues with his bull rush. He Stone could have just stepped down and go to the lower level to evade
Stopwatch. 5 minute warning.
Oh, nice hondo. He doesn't really have the rockets to continue. Wow. Pesita just YOLO'd. Ole! Oh. Mid fight, Pesita gets heavy. But it was a nice evasion of the bull rush by Stone. Like a Spanish matador. He sidestepped the onrush. Yeah, Stone is doing great damage. Yeah, just collect the shotgun and bring down hell. He even baits the bull rush. Oh, it's such a silly champion. It's just plus forward in somebody's face and you win a fight. So Pesita ties it up, but he doesn't win control. That is still in Stone's favor. Oh, but after he takes the heavy, everything gets removed. So yeah, he will be playing plus back until he can bait the bull rush. I think it's also pretty dangerous to be here. Ooh, he does connect his flame strike, and Pesita just lost Stone mid fight. So Stone gets back in the lead, and is also positioned for the mega health and a hit where Pesita is vacating. Ooh, that's an unfavorable fight for Stone. Oh, and Pesita is going to follow it up. Yeah, I think just deny this and do so as much as damage as you can. Oh, they even trade. This favors Stone by a lot. Oh, nice sidestepping, and he even used, I think, a little bit of a rocket boost to evade the bull rush. I don't know exactly how much damage you do when you do a rocket jump, but if you get hit by a max bull rush, it's 100 hit points. Yeah, so it's better to evade it with a rocket jump than to take the full on damage. Great damage with the fire strike. And wow, yeah, Sita was a little bit early, but has also the bull rush in his pocket to delete Stone. Yeah, Stone really needs to get a lightning gun for the next fight. Oh, he takes on a Hondi right after he gets through the portal. He has to deal with a full in-control cannonball. when he wastes his ability. No, this is not fair. With only 30 seconds left. And look at the stack of Zeta's working with. Stone has to hit at least 4 rails before Placita is available right now. Yeah, he tried. I think it went really well. Especially against Skillbearer. But it was not enough in the end. GG's. Congrats to Pesita. Yeah, Stone is second. Which isn't a bad place to be.